I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. Lost all ambition, worldly acclaim, acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love.
Welcome back, Ghouls and Goyles, to another speed painting of mine. Today is very Fallout themed in reference, high key, low key, in reference to the situation that we're going through right now. I'm quarantined in my own home, not by force of any kind, but just the stay-at-home order here in Michigan that's been in place for about a week now, I think. So in these dark times, I really like to go back to the post-apocalyptic stuff. And I know that a lot of the time that's really scary, especially in times like this when things are going so awry. But I think that we need a little humor about it, you know? Like, sure, maybe the world is ending, but that doesn't mean that we can't have a good time and that things won't ever be back to normal. Things are going to be okay, and we have to keep that in check. We, in our souls and in our hearts and in our minds, have to keep that in check. It's about community. It's about caring for one another. And so I think humor brings a lot of soul. So this is kind of just a silly draw with me little speed painting for you guys to try and brighten your spirits. This is Fallout themed, if you couldn't tell. This is my character from one of my playthroughs. I will try and play a little bit. Maybe I'll record some of it and show you guys in between. Anyways, I really love Fallout. I really love post-apocalyptic games. I'm super excited for Last of Us 2 to come out. And I hope you guys are enjoying your little apocalypse in your own homes.
Following total atomic annihilation, the rebuilding of this great nation of ours may fall to you. That's why we at Vault-Tec have prepared these educational materials for you to better understand the seven defining attributes that make you special.
You know, this whole situation, this whole thing got me thinking about what makes life special, what gives you purpose, what gives you value. And I think that this break in society, this break from having to live our normal lives, is actually incredibly helpful and good for our mental health. Obviously, a lot of people who struggle with mental health have a hard time being alone and being home alone. And I'm not saying that those things are good. I'm mostly talking about the ability to take a break from going to work, the ability to think more on who you want to become, where you want to go, what really gives you joy and purpose towards the things that you want your life to be about. So I'm hoping that I can create more videos like this in the future, because this is what I want to do. I want to create art. I want to create content that can be something more than just something to pass the time.
Growing up in a tiny
village, a farming community, it really didn't give me an idea of who I could become or what I could do with my life, what direction I could take it. And I think I've been really discouraged because of that, because of how little culture there was in my hometown, and because of the way that people thought about those sorts of things, about doing art and celebrating creativity. I think it just wasn't something that was entirely accepted or looked upon in a good way. It was thought of as more of a lazy occupation. And I want to express to anyone else out there who wants to pursue art that it is not a lazy occupation by any means. It can be exhausting mentally and emotionally, and even physically, if you sit here for hours and hours on end creating a piece just because you want it to be exactly how you planned it. It can be so overwhelming. But I say this not to scare you, but to instead hopefully inspire you to take action, to do something different, because after everything that's happening right now, I don't think we should ever go back to the way that things were. I think things need to change, and that this is the catalyst for that.
Eventually rolled back. People resettled, but they got comfortable and started taking things for granted. Folk got short of memory. All this has happened before.
So I've decided that as long as I can stay healthy throughout this quarantine period and throughout this time without a job, that I am going to be doing this. Every week, I will be creating an art piece, I will be doing something artistic, something that I want to pursue, and I'm going to start back up with creating my comic book. I'm gonna try and get it published on Webtoons as soon as possible, and I hope that you guys will be willing to join me in this process. Not only because do I need the support, but I know that you guys also need the support to think beyond and be more of what you want to become and do the things that you enjoy. And I hope that you are taking this opportunity to do those things, as long as they aren't detrimental to your mental health and the way that you feel about yourself. As long as you don't forget to have fun along the way, that is the whole point of this process. I originally meant for this video to be much more of a silly, fun little draw with me, and you can still view it as that, because I would love it if you would draw alongside me. But I wanted to cover these thoughts that have been going on, circling in my head a lot lately, because I know I'm not the only person. I know that these thoughts that I am having, that I am going through in this time of not having anything to do, or at least not anything that I have to do, that I want something to do, that I want to pursue my purpose. And I know a lot of other people feel that way. And so I want to encourage you guys to do that. And whatever you feel your purpose is, it doesn't have to be artistic. It can be something completely different, but something that makes you feel fulfilled and happy. And I think that's the best way to deal with this period of time.
your soul to their damnation, old man?
Well, what have we here? Another rad worshiping lunatic, that's what.
Your barbs do not harm me. I am shielded by my faith.
How about bullets? Faith shield you against those, too?
Who's she?
One of them children of Adam preachers. Started off as pests. Now they're more like a menace.
Do not sully this one with your blasphemy, old man. You. I suggest you go no further. Acadia is a nest of snakes. Beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
What's Acadia done to make you distrust them?
They supply Far Harbor with the means to turn back Adam's holy fog. You'd do well to avoid such creatures, and instead seek the only true master of this land.
All right, I'm listening. Tell me about Adam.
Tell you? Look around. You stride through his kingdom. A land blanketed beneath sacred fog. A land Adam has claimed for his children. And you may join our family if he deems you worthy.
Worthy? What do I have to do to join?
There is a ritual his children must perform. If you succeed, you will be rewarded with entrance into our family.
On second thought, I'm good.
So be it. But I would be mindful where you step. After all, you are in Adam's kingdom now.
I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for watching. I'm almost finished up right here. I will let you guys see the final transformation at the very end. But I just wanted to say thank you for joining me. I hope you guys are enjoying the other content that's been popping up on my channel. My husband and I have really been enjoying creating it, so I hope you guys are getting just as much enjoyment out of it as you are bored and stuck at home just like we are.
Clean, no fog. And we've arrived.